You know, I asked, all I asked for was accountability of my senior leaders. Follow me, and we will bring the whole fucking system down. I am honorable, and you can ask any Marine who served with me for 17 years. I dare you to ask them all and find out what I'm made of.
Well, the Lieutenant Colonel Scheller saga continues. The Marine Corps put out some documents that Task and Purpose has a hold of, and they say they were concerned about him talking about a revolution. Let's take a look. In a few of his videos, he says every generation needs a revolution.
Because when I am done with what I'm about to do, you all are going to need the jobs and the security.
Could be used tongue-in-cheek, but that really set the Marine Corps back. The Marine Corps officials were very unsettled by his repeated calls for revolution during remarks on Facebook and YouTube. And the revolution language is ultimately what the Marine Corps said landed him in the brig. His revolution comments seemed a little emotional. I really didn't take it too seriously.
My higher purpose, my path, the path of the Marine Corps, United States, I've come to a place where I feel at peace with making some further statements, and that's the purpose of this video.
But the Marine Corps did, and they went on to say he violated DOD's policy on limits of acts of protest and dissent for service members to engage in.
You have no idea what I'm capable of doing.
A lot of moving targets, but the revolution kept coming up, and we'll get to more kind of a clue in this whole saga. His attorney goes on to say, at no time did he really want to do a revolution. It was an emotional outcry for all the things that transpired, in particular with the 13 dead service members on the withdrawal. And his lawyer goes on to say he doesn't advocate for a violent overthrow of the government or any other insurrection. You start using that insurrection term after what happened on January 6th. Now, all of a sudden, you see how the Marine Corps had some cause for concern. But is there more to it than that? Now, the resurrection language wasn't the only reason he was in hot water, but I think that's what landed him in the brig. Got all the charges he's been brought up on. Take a look in the description. You see the charges that were proposed to be filed and were filed. And he is going to be court-martialed on all four of the charges they brought him up on. Now, this comment really gets into maybe it's a negotiation amongst the attorneys, but the Marine Corps officials believe that several of his comments could be construed as inciting a revolution, the charges say. Now we're getting into a whole nother level of potential issues. Now, this could be a bargaining chip, right? Prosecutors going to the defense. With the current climate, and after what happened on January 6th, you see how this could be used either for real concern or fake concern, I'll call it. The command's investigation really didn't like this, that he was calling on his supporters for an uprising. Follow me and we'll bring the whole fucking system down. We've heard that one. In the uprising and follow me, or the language, when you hear it in that context, multiple media clips, you can see both sides of this, I guess is my point. I'll give you at the end my editorial. I'll just go for the facts, at least on the legal documents that are out as of this morning. I really focus in on the second paragraph. Scheller engaged in prohibited dissent protest activities to include advocating for revolution, calling for the use of violence, and ensuring accountability of senior government leaders to effect political change, and for advocating for dismantling the current political military systems. Those are some big statements from the prosecution. Again, they could just be posturing. They are some pretty strong statements. I don't know how he's going to defend himself on, considering the amount of social media posts he's made on the topic. And we're going to get to the clue I mentioned earlier. I don't know if it's a I don't think it's by mistake, because who would have this book? And we'll get to that. He goes on to say, you know, the people in power are there because we allow them to. Another one of the statements that really could be questionable. I love and respect all people with different opinions. I possess the ability to inflict violence. That's a tough one. I'm asking for accountability at senior leaders. I love the Constitution, America. When he says that, and it wasn't just once, multiple times, and then again, revolution word. As you remember, the 26th was Schiller's coming out party on Facebook and LinkedIn, you know, wanting military leaders to be held accountable. I think we all felt that way. First video just seemed like he was just expressing his opinions. Not the wisest way for Lieutenant Colonel. I knew something was going to come of that. But then the preceding two other videos really put him over the top That's why I think he landed in the brig, and that's where I think these charges are going to get really tricky. Because there's many people in the comments all over the interwebs that think he's a martyr or a loose cannon. And is this helping the problem? Is it going to bring it down where you've got junior NCOs to decide, hey, we need to bring the system down too? You can see the Marine Corps' concern, because this has got a lot of publicity. The Marine Corps also got concerned, allegedly, when Scheller made some comments to an unnamed officer, here we go with the unnamed, that he expressed support, this is what they're reporting, for the January 6th activities. And if this statement's true, he's going to have a real problem. I'm going to burn the whole system down. This is him talking to another officer. We've heard that one. What if the guys in January were not a bunch of pussies? They were guys that knew what they were doing. They couldn't stop us. What could they do? And that's from another officer, allegedly. This is tough. I mean, this is not looking good for the man. Now, the Marine Corps says he made this to his XO, right? The officer below him in the battalion. And he said it once, but they didn't really say he brought it up again. Just saying it in the totality of what he said in every video, boy, that really makes it. The case doesn't look good, right? It's bad on its face. It's a bad look. His lawyer is trying to answer for Schiller's comments. These protesters were very little resistance, his attorney said. Imagine if they were hell-bent on violence, what they could have done. However, he's not saying he would do that. He's leaving a lot of breadcrumbs that if he were looking at it from the Marine Corps position, assuming this is all true, you'd go, wow, we've got a guy on our hands we need to really keep an eye on. And again, who knows if this is true? It's from the Marine Corps and their position. But let's get to the book. In his September 10th video, a real cloak and dagger thing happened. There's a book behind him. I didn't catch this. Sitting in a stack, it says Imperium. The book Imperium by Francis Parker Yaki, an American fascist who dedicated the book to the hero of the Second War, an apparent reference to Hitler, according to the Anti-Defamation League. So it's an uprising book, effectively. Now, he had it stacked behind him, and doesn't seem like this man does things by accident. His attorney goes on to say he hadn't read the book, you know, he wasn't familiar with it, but it's sitting behind him. That's some really bad luck, or there was some message to be delivered there. What's my opinion on this? I think he outkicked his punt coverage. He thought the first video he was getting a lot of support and kept going and going with this, with the chess pieces, the book behind him, the revolution comments. Even after he was arrested, or his first video, he talks to his XO about what happened on January 6th, what if some real pipe hitters were there type of thing. I don't like the concept of going for the revolution from within. I don't think we're to that point. I think he could have done it differently. Is there a need for change? Yes. Is the manner in which he's doing it going to be a good thing for everybody in the short run? No. I don't know enough about what his plan is. It keeps saying, follow me. I've got a plan. I don't think he does anything by accident. I think he is going to spend time in the brig. I think based on the environment after January 6th, this is going to be looked at harsh. Maybe they'll take it off the table and just, if he agrees to the four charges or six charges he's up against. But the other language, the incites insurrection language, it's tough. That's a tough hurdle to get over based on this reporting and the documents the Marine Corps is presenting. You may say, JT, what about Miley? We're not talking about Miley. Miley's exempt from this, apparently. That makes no difference in this case. Miley's got a get-out-of-jail-free pass, apparently. He can do whatever the hell he wants. Schiller's now could be the scapegoat, could be a martyr. There's lots of things he could be called here, but he's got a real damn problem with the Marine Corps. And these charges, they don't agree to something, and I don't know why the Marine Corps would, because then you're giving him, he is a martyr, to people below who don't like the system and want to tear it down. And I'm not sure we're quite there on the tearing it down point. I think in the general officers that become politicians, they're a bunch of shitbags. But I think most of the guys in don't need a reason for this uprising discussion. I don't think it does anything good for us as a nation, a Marine Corps. Thanks for watching.